Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to use the Super Image Denoiser add-on version 2.8 for Blender 2.8 3 and above. First you need to install the add-on. To do so, download it for free on the Gumroad page, link in the description. Then in Blender, go to Edit, Preferences, click on Add-ons, Install. Then you select the zip file and click Install Add-on. Now enable the checkbox. To use the seed, you need to add it to your scene. To do so, you go to the render properties, then scroll down to create super denoiser. Here you can see seed and the brand new temporal denoiser setting. Seed works wonders on still images and works very well on animation. You have three quality settings. Super, being the most precise but slowest. High, being more precise than standard and faster than super. And standard, which is very fast but has a lot of artifacts. Personally, I use Super for final renders and Standard for previews. Render passes allow you to select which passes should be used when denoising. With this, you can optimize the denoiser to only use the passes you actually have in your scene. Here we also have some advanced settings. Refresh Seed will refresh the denoiser when you click the denoiser button. In previous versions, it completely reset the compositor. This will no longer be the case. Use Multilayer EXR will create an additional output file that contains each individually denoised pass. This is useful if you want to use the EXR file in an external program to edit your image or animation. At the very bottom is the button that adds a denoiser. Seed 2.8 is compatible with Cycles, LuxCore and Octane. In Seed 2.8 there is now a new button up here. This is the temporal denoiser. It can utilize the information from a previous and the next frame. With it you have more consistency between frames. The downside is, it only works for animations. You first have to specify where you want to save the noisy frames. You can select the folder with this button here. After you have done that, select the folder for the denoised frames. Now you can click on Render Noisy Frames. This is step 1 of 2 you need to do. It will render EXR files into the specified Noisy Frames folder. Blender will not respond during that time. But you can see your render progress in the folder as the images appear. You now need to tweak some settings. They will differ from scene to scene, so there cannot be a rule of thumb. The passes here are similar to the passes you see in Seed. If you have this type of material, leave it on. And finally, you can click Denoise Noisy Frames. This is the second step to get the clean images. Blender will once again freeze until the denoising is finished. But you can go up here, click on Window, toggle System Console. There you can see the denoising progress. After that finished, you will have the denoised EXR files in the folder you set above. The temporal denoiser only works in cycles and can only be used for animations. For anything else, it won't work. Now here I have some scenes to show you how much better Seed is compared to any other denoiser available for Blender. Thank you for watching. See you next time.